None of the arguments raised by Pakistan concerning the applicability of Article 36 of the Vienna Convention to the case of Mr. Jadhav can be upheld. The court thus concludes that the Vienna Convention is applicable in the present case, regardless of the allegations that Mr. Jadhav was engaged in espionage activities.
So in a major victory today for India, the International Court of Justice has ruled that Pakistan violated the Vienna Convention on Consular Relations in its treatment of Kulbhushan Jadhav, the Indian national who'd been arrested by them. Now it's been what, 3 years ago, and who'd been convicted and sentenced to death by a Pakistan military court for espionage and terrorism offences in early 2017. Now, the International Court of Justice had previously also passed a provisional measures order at India's request in May 2017, staying the execution of Jadhav, and the court has said that that stay on execution has to continue till such time as it considers an effective review and reconsideration of the conviction and sentence of Jadhav. Now, the court has ordered this effective review and reconsideration because of, as we pointed out, the violations of the Vienna Convention. Why has the court said that Pakistan violated the Vienna Convention? Now, Jadhav was a foreign national. Under international law, under this specific treaty, there is a requirement that the moment country A picks up foreign national from country B, they have to inform that foreign national that he can access the consular officials of his own country, of country A, and that country, and they then also have to inform country A that they have arrested or detained a foreign national from that country. Now, these are specific obligations under Article 36 1b and 1c of this Vienna Convention on Consular Relations. What Pakistan in this case did was they neither informed Jadhav that he had a right to this, nor did they inform India about having even picked up Jadhav for over 3 weeks, 22 days in fact. They did not inform India. And even after informing India, they did not provide India consular access to Jadhav. So on these three counts, the court said that Pakistan violated the law because they should have informed Jadhav his rights, they should have informed India that they had Jadhav, and they should have then, the moment India asked for it, given India access to Jadhav. To reach this conclusion, the court, the main thing which the court had to do was strike down Pakistan's objection to this whole thing, where Pakistan said that Jadhav is a spy and therefore spies don't get rights to consular access. The court rejected this contention, said it was not supported by either the treaty or its travel preparatories, which is the sort of discussions which led to the treaty, or by customary international law. India had asked that, look, since this has happened, they had also asked for the court to annul the decision of the military court in Pakistan and therefore ensure that Jadhav was released and repatriated to India immediately. Now, the court has said that that's not within their scope of what they can do here. The violation of the law only relates to the process of the conviction and the sentence for Jadhav, not the conviction and sentence itself. So as a result, they said that that needs to be effectively reconsidered. And they've given some very strong comments to Pakistan to make sure that that's the case. They point out that there has that you can't just be, it can't just be a formality. It can't just be any sort of review which Pakistan conducts and says it's all over and done with. It has to genuinely be an effective review of his trial. And India will now also get consular access to Jadhav, and he will therefore be able to get India's assistance in defending himself in the court before it goes forward. The big thing for India is we'll now be having to look forward to see, is Pakistan actually going to effectively comply with the orders of the court? If there's any problems with that, then obviously we can take them back to the court and say that they failed to comply with it. Beyond that, of course, the court hasn't given any further directions. The main takeaway, of course, for Jadhav himself is that he's not going to be executed, and he cannot be executed till this effective review process is considered. So India will obviously be keeping track of this. Pakistan is now under an obligation to follow this. And in the end, the winner probably is Jadhav himself.